the stunning state of Tasmania. Scenic. Picturesque. This playground for the adventurous is also known for its epic roads. It's the CAMS Australian Rally Championship. A forest symphony that's one part nature, one part danger. And welcome to the CAMS Australian Rally Championship, Round 4, Subaru Rally Tasmania. It's been 10 years since the ARC last visited this spectacular countryside, a highly anticipated return made possible by the Tasmanian government through Events Tasmania. This is the home round for some of the series' most competitive teams, and it marks the start of the second half of season 2018.
In Perth, we managed to control the rally from start to finish fairly comfortably. We had a nice road position there, being car-free on the road, which definitely helped. Going into Rally of Canberra, we tried to take the same approach, and the pace was really good, but day two, we hit a water splash, and I didn't have the heat event on, but still managed to win the event and score some really good points.
This year's been really up and down for us. Obviously, we had the disappointment in Ballarat, hitting the kangaroo, and then everything started to get back on track with third in WA, and then we had a few issues and broke three rims in Canberra and lost a heap of time. So it's been very up and down, so looking forward to getting our championship back on track here.
In WA, we made a mistake and went off the road, completely my fault, but you know, that left us, I guess, chasing from that point on. And then in Canberra, we were having a good event until we had a turbo failure, which is disappointing to say the least. You know, other than that, the car's been very reliable so far this year.
We did well in WA, second there, and we were second in Canberra until a turbo failure on the last day dropped us back to third. But still strong results. We're still in the hunt, so we'll see if we can annoy them again this weekend.
Subaru Rally Tasmania is a sprint event broken into two heats, and the untamed gravel roads wind their way through picturesque forests. They're fast, narrow, slippery, and they haven't seen competition in decades, so this presents the teams with a very real challenge. The first step, recce.
We're on recce, and it's a very, very important time. Obviously, this is where we get to make the pace notes for the weekend. We're trying to learn about the surface, the climate, you know, the camber of the road, the elevation, all those sorts of things we're trying to take into account on recce. And they can have effect on car setup and tyre choice as well come day one of the rally.
The best way I can describe a navigator's role or a co-driver's role in a rally car is it's you're almost like a personal assistant or an executive assistant. The most important part of any rally is your preparation, and recce is probably the most important part of that preparation. So I'm usually looking at maps and stages and that sort of stuff, you know, weeks or months before the actual event itself. The more you can get done on reconnaissance, the better. It means there's less to think about, basically, when you're on the rally itself. You know, you can free up brain cells to deal with other stuff that's happening on the day.
The new generation of drivers in the Australian Rally Championship has now been matched by a new generation car. This is the Skoda Fabia R5. It's factory developed, and it's virtually a mini WRC car. It's very, very fast. Nearly 200 Fabia R5s have rolled out of the Czech Republic factory. The Work Skoda team have already claimed back-to-back WRC 2 titles and set up an impressive customer program. The heart of the Fabia R5, a turbocharged 1.6-litre four-cylinder motor making 205 kilowatts and 420 newton-metres of torque. It's four-wheel drive with a five-speed sequential gearbox capable of 200 kilometres per hour. Highly developed independent suspension is key to keeping the 1,200-kilogram Fabia firmly planted on the ground. perfect environment to see the Skoda Fabia R5, the opening stage of Subaru Rally Tasmania, the Examiner Super Special Stage. Location for the opening heat, State Forest, northeast of Launceston. Five stages repeated twice, separated by a midday service park pause. The conditions? Crisp. A spectacular morning frost, air and road temperatures below zero. First on the road, championship leader Eli Evans. Third in the points, Harry Bates. Examiner Super Special Stage winner, Steve Glennie. Adrian Coppen in the second Skoda Fabia R5. ...2016 Australian Rally Champion, Molly Taylor. Les Walkden Racing runs this Subaru WRX. Rally Tasmania, their home event. The opening forest stage, a dramatic start to the day. A power outage in the Toyota Yaris AP4. It cost 14 minutes. For second in the championship, Glennie, bigger problems. Glennie and co-driver Andy Sarandis, thankfully okay. The Subaru stranded with a broken radiator. Eli Evans, untouchable.
Short right six, it's right seven, late line, through finish, short right six, left six long, yep.
The Tasmanian fans not deterred by the fresh morning. Left puncture for Lewis Bates. A great team effort. Co-driver Dale Moskett and Lewis back on the road in the Toyota Corolla S2000 with only a short delay. Headed into the service, Eli Evans was already out to a 2 minute lead.
Short left seven, late. Right eight, 50. Fast left three, Hagen. 50. Turn fast, left three.
We've got to keep your concentration up, so we'll just try and keep our speed up and try and be as neat as we can. It only takes one corner to throw it all away, so we'll keep the pace on and hopefully we can finish with a nice clean run in the afternoon.
Rallying is all about repairing things in a very short space of time. So we're used to the 10-minute services, 20-minute services and things, and getting the car back to where it needs to be. So these boys are well drilled at that. So it's just go, go, go and get us back out there.
Overcast conditions for the afternoon stages of Heat 1, Subaru Rally Tasmania. Incredibly, the Comtel Communications Subaru WRX made it back out to the forest.
Get to the end and see where we end up. Go again tomorrow.
Evans in the MRF Skoda continued to build the lead.
50. Short right two opens. Long. Then short right seven line.
Molly Taylor, second. now with a healthy buffer to Adrian Coppen.
Slow slight left for the four right, Titans minus. And four left opens, nips up.
Every time I come down to Tassie, I always try to fit in a run up the Cataract Gorge in Launceston, just, you know, almost in town. It's not far at all, and it's absolutely beautiful. Lots of good coffee shops, lots of good cafes as well, so plenty of coffee happening this weekend.
After the lunch service, Harry Bates, the big mover. After falling as low as 13th, Harry and co-driver John McCarthy clawed their way back to 8th. To the two-wheel drive class, and a good battle between Adam Kaplan in the Nissan 370Z and Ben Hayes in the thumb-pick, always sideways, Holden Commodore SS. Local Subaru driver Mark Butcher, an impressive fifth outright and first of the 23 contesting the Tasmanian State Rally Championship. The clean sweep of all 10 stages, Eli Evans and Ben Searcy nailed a perfect day.
Left 9, Titans fast 7.
Flat out as fast as I could all day. The Skoda ran faultlessly. We had no issues at all, so I'm keeping it pretty easy for the guys at service now.
Subaru car in a Subaru event. Tasmanian car, Tasmanian event. Are you feeling the love?
Definitely feeling the love. You know, Les, all the boys are based out in Launceston. They're just up the road, so so good to be able to be having a good result with these guys in their backyard and all the local support. So it's been perfect.
Eli Evans' dominant day extended his championship lead. Incredibly, he'd already grabbed the bonus point for most stage wins with a whole day to spare. Molly Taylor credited a solid bank of points at her team's home event. Another local crew, Marcus and Scott Walkham, finished inside the top five with their rebuilt Peugeot AP4. Celebrating 50 years of the CAMS Australian Rally Championship, ARC Heroes today focuses on the cars that shape the sport. Manufacturers have always been keen to display their mix of speed and endurance in the harsh Aussie conditions. Early days, the ARC, a true Ford versus Holden battle, with XC1 Tiranas claiming four titles. Over to the 70s and 80s, and it was Datsuns, the weapons of choice, with the Datto 1600 still a popular car today. In the 90s, it was Japanese domination. WRC spec four-wheel drive machines wowing crowds across the country, and the factory-backed Subaru WRXs claiming 10 straight drivers' titles in the most competitive era the sport has ever seen. Today, the modern era, it's all about the AP4 and R5 spec cars that are capable of incredible speeds. In total, there have been 12 different manufacturers claim the drivers' titles dating back down to 1968. Subaru have claimed twice as many as any other car maker. Final day of Subaru Rally Tasmania. Location, the Retreat Forest north of Launceston. The conditions, torrential rain. The weather took a massive turn overnight. First on the slippery road, Heat 1 winner Eli Evans. Sprint format offers Harry Bates a chance to pull some points back. Same story for Steve Glennie. Contending for the outright podium, Molly Taylor and Adrian Coppen.
Fast short right five, hard to see here. 70.
A mistake from Eli Evans. The car stalled, the battery dead. 5 minutes lost. Molly Taylor stuck in the same spot.
Keep going. When you see the corner on your right, keep going.
right over crest 100. In 6 flat, minus 200.
Harry Bates won his first stage of the weekend.
In 5 right plus on crest, over finish. And 5 left. Yep, 5 left here.
The goal for Evans was clear. Get back the 5 minutes. Ahead of the day's third stage, disappointment for Harry Bates. A flat battery, his Heat 2 lead gone. Steve Glennie, the new Heat 2 leader, ahead of the midday service break. A remarkable turnaround after his Heat 1 crash. Subaru Rally Tasmania is so excitingly poised with 3 stages to go. At the midday service, it's this car, Steve Glennie, leading Heat 2. Remember, this car was in pieces yesterday after an accident in the early stages. Molly Taylor sitting second, just 9 seconds behind him. Adrian Coppin, 11 seconds off the pace. The spin for Eli Evans earlier today has meant that he's got 2 minutes and 13 seconds to make up with 3 stages to go. If he can't do that, Molly Taylor will be the overall and outright rally winner.
It's my first time really to Launceston, and it's a really cool place where you've got the river flowing right through the centre of town, and Tasmanian people are probably the friendliest Australians you can meet, and he's no exception.
Final 3 stages of Subaru Rally Tasmania. The spectacular countryside shrouded in low cloud and heavy rain. Just 9 seconds separated Heat 2 leader Steve Glennie from Molly Taylor. Adrian Coppin only another 2 seconds behind. Eli Evans had to catch Molly Taylor to win the event. The equation, 124 seconds in 56 kilometres. Surely he couldn't. ...68 seconds back in the first stage. Final stage, Evans still had 20 seconds to find. Steve Glennie had built a big enough gap to win Heat 2. A great result on home soil. But Evan's sights were set firmly on Molly Taylor.
Long 6 left. So long 6 left. And a short 4-5 right plus on crest. Little late 40. Cut 4 left minus on crest 80.
Time, 58 seconds quicker, more than enough to earn the overall rally win.
You know, after losing 5 minutes, I was a bit dejected after the first stage, but had to do the Evans name proud and have a go and drive as fast as I could. So that's what we did and got us the win for the weekend.
Overall, the event went really well, and the car was perfect all weekend, and just really nice to have a run where it all sort of falls into place after a few tricky events. 2 rounds to go, you know, anything can happen, it's rallying, so we just need to keep getting good results. We need to be on the podium every round, and so that's what we need to keep trying to do, and yeah, see where we're at the end of all that.
Really happy with third for the weekend. Unfortunately, it's my last event for the year, so all my focus now goes on to my job, which is Rally Australia, but had a really good battle with Molly today. Every day's a school day when you're doing a rally, so learnt lots more about the car, and yeah, can't wait for next year.
Eli Evans and Ben Searcy claimed 14 of the 17 stages in their third rally win in a row. Taylor and Coppen equal on points for the round. Taylor got the nod due to a quicker overall time. Great performances from the Walkhams, Lewis Bates and Mark Butcher. The championship picture with two rounds to play. Evans extends his lead. Glennie hangs on to second with his stirring Heat 2 win. And the fight is on for third between Bates and Taylor. Thanks to the Tasmanian Government and Events Tasmania for their support of the CAMS Australian Rally Championship. From here, the series heads over to South Australia and then Rally Australia for the season finale. Come and check out the world's best rally drivers tackle the Coffs Coast, New South Wales this November. Grab your tickets at Ticketek. Also remember to check out the ARC website and Facebook page for all the latest news as it breaks. We'll see you on the Coffs Coast. Thanks for watching.
Line. Right 6. Left 8, 100. Caution, right 4, long. Slight. 70. Through finish 100.